Welcome back to the channel. This is going to be a walkthrough of ohsint, a easy beginner challenge CTF in Google Docking, and going to use some open source intelligence to solve this. So the only thing we have, which is a bit strange for me anyway, is just an image. So we're starting with an image and that's it. So there's no box to like virtual machine to start up or anything like that. It's all just, the Flamin thing. So I've already downloaded it. So not to ruin the surprise, but I have actually gone through this, this box. So I know what's up and I will explain a few things along the way. So we'll go ahead and download that and we'll give it a bit of an inspect, bit of a hover there. What do we got? Windows XP, JPEG. So by the untrained eye, we don't have anything here. No hidden imagery. It looks just like a pretty basic image. So we need to use something to assess this little closer. So if we look at our hint here, so we've got our list of questions. So a few questions. What is the user's avatar of? What is this user's avatar of? So like makes zero sense. So my first intuition was like, let's just go find it first. So it's just on the desktop. So, you know, is there anything unusual about it if we just look at it and we can run file against it and it is indeed a JPEG? So the hint here is EXIF tool. So when we look up EXIF tool, we can find that this is a pretty popular command line application, Perl library for metadata. So I'm not an expert in this, but I know when we take photos that there is more data behind the photo than just the photo itself, the pixels and whatnot. So we can go ahead and sudo apt install xf tool like so. I've already got it installed. So once it's installed, we can just go ahead and look at the man page for that EXIF tool. We can see here it read and write meta information in files. So not just JPEGs, but you know, all files. So there's a lot that this thing can do, but we can go ahead and just run it by default against our image there and we get some information here. So going through this, it's really a case of like what sticks out at us, okay? So this is where we take our time. So version number of the tool, you know, the file directory, things that we already know. You know, the permissions, we could already see that. Nothing really unique here, you know, blah, blah, blah. Copyright. Now, I must admit, when I first saw that, I did sort of skip over it. And this is sort of what's hard about like going through this stuff is it's not like a video game where there will be a light shining towards somewhere that us as the player, we know that we need to go that way. Like we have to use some critical thinking here. I honestly skipped over this. I just went, okay, I don't know what that is. It's probably not too important. Kept looking and I was like, okay, well maybe, you know, we've got some GPS coordination, so maybe we do something with that, and maybe this coding baseline, maybe that's something. But then I thought back to copyright. I'm like, you know, you can just sort of whatever in a copyright. I mean, you can manipulate all this metadata and put whatever, but I'm like, I don't know, I think that this is a thing. So let's go ahead and just do some Google Docking. So you can see here, I've already gone to these links, and this is it. Like, this is open source intelligence. And it took me a little bit to get my head around, to be honest, because I thought we were going to stay here. And this is what I'm used to. I'm used to cybersecurity. I'm used to learning hacking in, you know, the terminal. Like, this is where, you know, we do stuff. But open source intelligence is using the internet. So this is kind of wild for my little brain. The next thing I made a mistake in when going through this is I only looked at Twitter. I just saw Twitter and I just assumed that the rest were challenges. I didn't even look at these other two. So learn from me, and what my future self will be better at is actually taking the time to look at the search results. So we can see here we have a Twitter profile. then we have a WordPress.com blog, and then we have a GitHub repo. And then the giveaway is, you know, these are all anything that says tryhackme or writeup. You know, we can confidently say that these are, yeah. So people have been looking up the Gmail and some spy talks, whatever that is. Yeah, so those are just write-ups, but our focus is on these three. And this is really cool. I have seen this in other CTS, like from watching like John Hammond videos and other YouTubers and that, where this is a part of the challenge where we'll have fake, you know, Twitter accounts or Facebook accounts that we can go and try and hack. So yeah, so we've let's look at these three in order. And if we go back to what is the user's avatar of, pretty confident out of all of our three accounts that we can focus on that the avatar is indeed of a CAT. Nice. What city is this person in? Now, again, I made the mistake of not looking at the other options that I just was here and I was like, what? Oh man, I was looking at comments and there was some like base64 encoded comments. I'm like, oh, is this a part of it? I sort of, yeah, but yeah, don't waste your time. This is an easy challenge after all. So I go too deep too fast. That's another thing. So let's just flick through. So we've got on this one, I'm in New York right now. So I'll update the site right away with new photos. Okay, so we've got Hello World. From my house, I can get free Wi-Fi, and we have some sort of MAC address looking thing back on Twitter. So this isn't helping. We can see here that they are in New York, but our question is, what city is the person in? And I mean, it could be New York. I mean, I'm just playing. I know it's not. So let's go ahead and look over here at the GitHub repo, and we can see that this is the only repo that they have is this people finder, which I think is in spirit. So it says, hi, I am from London. That is what we're after. Now, this next one, and yeah, man, I got a story. BSSID plus wiggle.net. So this was totally new to me. So let's just go check out wiggle.net. If we look here, we do have some more information. This is linking to our Twitter. Talking about more photos, and here, email me if you want. Before we go down that rabbit hole, let's just go over, I spelled it wrong, didn't I? Let's just look up Weagle. There we go. What's the SSID of the WAP he connected to? So we need to use this website. Okay, you will need to make an account in order to Weagle work, and you do not need to use your actual personal information. You can just go ahead and use whatever you want. The idea here is we have this hint, this BSSID, which I did look up what it stood for and I can't remember, but we can use this MAC address looking thing, put it in here as you can see in my other attempts, paste that in, and we can query the database to find where he's at. This is where I had the issue. So if we sort of look around, The map didn't really take me anywhere straight away. Like, I can't actually see anything on the map. There is something in London, and I must admit, this did not work out well for me when I first did this. I punched it in, and I didn't see anything, and I didn't take my time of looking around the map. And I must admit, like, that's... It stands out now because I know what I'm looking for, but... You know, if you tried this like me, don't feel silly that you didn't see it or it didn't work. So we can see here that this MAC address actually does come up on their database, which is just nuts. I was reading an article about this website and it's kind of crazy. Okay, so this is actually new territory. I don't know how to, what is the SSID of the WAP he connected to? So can I interact with this? There is a name. There is a name. It's very small. I definitely didn't copy this the first time. It should work. This is the idea of the wireless access point that he connected to. This is crazy. So what's his personal address? So we can find that out if we go back to his GitHub. Interestingly enough, if we actually go to his pull requests, there's a pull request here of that README file. Where he's added, message me on Twitter for my email, probably not a good idea to give out publicly. Like, we can see, I'm a little confused because it's got it here. So the pull request was made, meaning, but he committed it, but he didn't like push it to the master branch. So that's why we don't see this green message. Instead, we still see, I think that's how GitHub works. Bit of an interesting thing just I found from poking around. So what site did you find his email address on? So we found it on GitHub. Where has he gone on holiday? So if we go back here, I'm in New York right now. New York. Oops. We can paste that in there. So this is all, like, it's all pretty straightforward. And what is this person's password? Okay. I had some issues with this room. Like, this didn't work for me the first time because I was silly. It annoyed me a little bit, if I'm being really honest. I only found this from looking at another write-up. So if we use our inspects and we can hover over, we can see that there is a blank area here. And indeed, there is just a, like, if we just change this to 000000, we can see here that the text is actually on the website. It was just hidden. So in one way, that's, oh, cool. Like a little thing, like make sure you look around and inspect people's websites. Like, you know, you might find something like this, but at the same time, like, who does this? I think that's what sort of annoyed me about this. Like, I would have never, ever, ever found this. I don't think I would have ever found it. Some part of me thinks I would have, but another part of me is like, I wouldn't have looked there because I guess in my head, like this part, who puts a password on the front? I don't know. I guess I'm probably just, I've missed the reason that it's just a bit of fun. It's not supposed to be like super serious, but I guess that's just my brain. And I think it was really from when things went wrong on the wiggle.net for me that it sort of all started to spiral apart. So I didn't have the best experience with ohsint. I don't think that's at the fault of the tryhackme or the creator. I think it's just more me. But anyway, that was my experience. It was fun to go through the first time, even though it was quite infuriating, but I much prefer going through a second time and sharing it in this format. This was much better. It was nice when things actually worked out and getting to show you. So I hope you enjoyed. This has been ohsint from tryhackme. Go show some love to the creator and the community. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you found it helpful, please let me know. Leave a nice comment. It does help me. It's very motivating to see some positive comments in the description. If you have any feedback, like if I've done anything different or to you or anything like that, I'm always keen to improve. So that would be great. And last thing from me is I have a monthly newsletter that I thought I would let you know about, like let you in on. So if you want to, there's a link below where it's just a little friendly monthly update, and I still have to write last month's, but yeah, I'm usually onto it. Anyway, that has been the video. Enjoy.